Good day, friends. I have got another fun lesson for you. This is going to be a Scribble Car. I like to always name my files before I get started. I think you should as well, so you don't lose track of what you were getting done. As I mentioned, it is going to be a Scribble Car, so bring out the Scribble. And then when you get in Scribble, draw a super awesome car body. So I'm drawing my car body like this. If you don't like what you did, you can clear the whole thing and start over. I'm going to draw a little bit of a back tail, come across, do my roof, have it come down, have a sweet sloped, have a sweet front end. I'm going to fill this all in using the super cool filled shape tool. Notice it traces the outside of your edges. So if you're just careful and stay to the outside edges, it is pretty easy to make your design fill in one quick step. If you miss an area, just get it a second time. And if you're happy, you can say groovy. If you want to change something, you can do it again and again until you are happy. I'm going to hit done and I'm going to enter this project. Notice the car is laying the wrong way. I'm going to rotate it 90 degrees. If you keep your mouse close to the vehicle, then it rotates on the little lines inside, which are much easier. If you go outside, it goes 1 degree at a time, which is a problem. I want my car to be up on the work plane, so I'm going to hit the letter D, and you're going to notice that it pops right to level zero. I'm going to stretch it out so it's a little wider, which makes it look a little bit more like a real car. I want to cut out the window area, and I'm going to do that with a really cool round roof. When I bring it in, I'm going to make it a hole. I'm going to move it inside my vehicle, but I'm going to make it a little wider than my vehicle so I can see it poking out both sides. I am right-click rotating so that you can see how I orbit. I'll lift this up near the top. I can stretch it out till I'm happy with where it is aligned. If you ever make a mistake like I just did and move something else, just do Control Z. Now I've got the cone grabbed and I can get it so it's just like I want it. Use the arrow keys, pull it up one more notch, and I'm going to hit group to see how that looks. Boom, I have cut out the side of my car, or the side windows. I'm going to cut out the front windows also using a hole box. Once again, I'm going to get it lined up with my car, but this one I want it to be less than the whole car. So there's got a little bit of room holding together. I need those two pieces to be aligned. So my windshield is going to be in the center of my vehicle. And then I'm going to lift it up and I'm going to use the arrow keys to push it through. Notice it is too thick and it's not long enough. So I'm going to make it a little longer and a little shorter. And when I'm happy, I can grab and group it. And that's going to be my finished bit. Let's add some awesome wheels to our car. Start by grabbing the work plane and putting it on the side of your car, switching from basic shapes to all shapes. Scroll through that list and you will find the amazing wheel tool. There are many ways you can change it, but I'm going to leave mine the same. I'm going to hold down shift, grab one of those white corners, and shrink it till it fits my car. When I nudge it up into place, I can double check to make sure it's the exact size I want. I'm going to shrink it one more time, and I think that is going to be just awesome. I'm going to do Control D, or use this to duplicate, nudge that one to the front. Click on shift so that both are selected, and I want to make them black. I'm going to group those. I'm going to duplicate them with Control D. I'm going to push them way over to the other side and flip them. That way the outside of the wheel is faced the way it's supposed to. This is one of my favorite tricks right now. I'm going to use the work plane and put it on this side of the car right where I want to attach it. When you press the letter D, bam, it drops it right where you want. I'm going to press W and put the work plane to the bottom. I'm going to pick a cooler blue. I'm a Lions fan, so we're going to go Honolulu blue. I'm going to group my current design. And then once it finishes grouping, I am going to set it to multicolor. By simply clicking the current color, and there's the multicolor button. You can add so many cool things to this car. I'm going to start by adding my headlights. I want them to be flat, so let me show you the trick I'm going to use to make that happen. First, I'm going to go to basic shapes, and I'm going to just bring a box out. It gives me the flat location where I can set my headlights. I'm going to make headlights out of the half sphere. I'm going to shrink them down to the size I want, and then I'm just going to nudge them into place using the arrow keys and the cool push-pull tool. I'm going to go up a couple clicks, make sure that it sticks inside the shape, so I'm going to make it a little longer. And those are going to be my headlights. I'm going to make them yellow. I'm going to do Control D, and I'm going to move one to the other side with the arrow keys as well. When I'm happy, I'm going to take that whole part of the project, and I'm going to group it as well. Let's add one more cool part, and we're going to use Scribble to do it. Let's delete the pieces that we just added. I'm going to hit delete even while it's still grouping. I'm going to set my work plane back to the ground, and I'm going to bring in one more scribble so that I can make a very cool fin in the back. There's my scribble command, and then I'm going to make my fin look like this. It's going to have a sloped little tower area, and then it's going to have the cool fin piece that gets a little bit bigger and rounded at the end. Make sure that's nice and smooth. Get rid of that little nugget down there. And I'm going to call it done. When this lands in my project, let's see which way it's oriented. It is not oriented the way I want, but that's where I simply use the rotate. Once again, stay close to the shape so you can use the long lines. I'm going to spin it this way as well. I could have also used flip. I'm going to move it over so it's arranged in the same angle as my car. And then I am going to cut out the bottom of it so that there's a nice hole instead of a one piece here. I'm going to do that, of course, with a box. Make that box a little thinner. Shrink it to the right height. Let's use Fit View to selection so I can see how I'm doing on what I want to cut. That looks better. I'm going to take the three of these items and I'm going to align them this way. Then I'm going to take these two items and I'm going to group them. Pretty nifty, except I had some below ground I didn't notice. So I'm going to make this bigger and then move it down. So I'm sure I'm cutting it all this time. And I have now got a nifty fin that I can pull up. And then I'm going to use the arrow keys to move it forward so that way it stays lined up just the way I want it. You can do all kinds of crazy things. This may be where you want to do the little 1 degree movements to change the tilt of it. But you can make it look as cool as you want. There's so much room for you to have fun, add labels to your car like I did with my little Lions Rule car, my little One Pride bumper sticker on the back. But hey friends, I'm going to leave that up to you. When you are all done, I will remind you that you can group it. And then if your work plane is set to normal, when you hit the letter D, it will pop it up so it's above ground just like it's supposed to be. Congratulations on making this awesome design. Friends, if you found this useful at all, please hit that like button. If you haven't subscribed, please hit the subscribe button. And if you want to be the first to know when there's a brand new movie from me, HLModTech, hit that notification bell. Last but not least, if you have a question or a comment, leave it down below. Have a great day. Go Lions.